Hey everyone, Patrick CK here with episode 5 of 3D printing with the Monoprice Maker Select V2. I hope you liked the new intro. In this episode, we are going to look at another important mod that will help improve the quality of our prints. This time around, we're going to focus on improving the cooling situation of the V2 by replacing the stock cooling fan and shroud with the Dii Cooler aftermarket fan kit and accompanying shroud that we will print. One reason I chose to go with this mod was because many of you peeps suggested it, so I'd like to say thank you all for that. And two, the last benchy we printed had a few imperfections that I believe can be improved with better cooling, in particular the top of the front window and the ceiling of the wheelhouse were a little messy, as you can see here. This is due to the printer trying to bridge the gap and the filament not cooling fast enough to make it all the way across in one pass. So you are left with this drooping edge for several passes until it builds up enough to cover the gap. Here's why that happened. The stock cooling setup is composed of a 40mm open intake style fan that blows its air into a shroud toward a nozzle from one direction. As you can see, only a fraction of the air actually will get in contact with the nozzle. This new setup will replace the stock fan and shroud with a larger 50mm blower style fan that will push the air into a cleverly designed shroud that then focuses the air directly onto the nozzle from 360 degrees. Having 360 degrees of cooling means that no matter which way the filament is flowing, it will get a consistent amount of cooling air. This is especially important for PLA filament that needs to be cooled the second it gets extruded. Unlike the brace mod from episode 3, this time I opted for a pre-assembled kit from the ultimate3dprintingstore.com. The kit includes one M4 by 20mm screw, two M3 by 12mm screws, one M4 lock nut, two M3 lock nuts, and of course the 50 by 15mm brushless blower style fan. When I bought the kit, it was $12.95. In this case, I don't believe it would have been cheaper to source the pieces individually, especially for the right sized and mounted blower style fan, although I did find a similar one on Amazon for around $8. Again though, I'd go with the full kit if you can get it for the same price I did. Link to the fan and hardware kit in the description. The only thing the kit doesn't include is the new shroud, which we will print ourselves. The option to have this printed professionally is available on Thingiverse for a cost if you want the best result the first time. But what's the fun in that? You can find the files on Thingiverse at the link in the description. It's a good idea to use ABS filament instead of PLA to print the shroud, because once installed it may warp or simply melt from the heat of the nozzle during normal printing. Of course, ABS has a host of other benefits that we will discuss in another video. I'll be using Hatchbox brand ABS filament to create this shroud. Let's get to printing. I wanted to have a quick print side chat. I just wanted to say thank you to all my subscribers and viewers for the great feedback. I truly appreciate it. If you would like to support my channel financially, there are two avenues. The easiest, and one I've seen many of you do already, and again, I very much thank you for it, is to use my Amazon affiliate link to purchase the items I talk about in the video. The other is to contribute to my GoFundMe account, whose proceeds will go to paying down my student loans. I know this is a wholly selfish request, but the sooner it's paid off, the sooner I can quit my second job and focus on providing more content and hopefully not take so long to get another video out. Links to both in the description. That's it for the begging. Thanks again everyone. Back to the printing. I think this is the coolest part of the shroud and the key to providing the 360 degrees of cooling. These curved fins grab the air as it gets blown in and directs it toward the nozzle. This is an ingenious design and oh so effective. Here we have the first finished shroud. Obviously not perfect, a bit of stringing on the inside and across the screw hole mounts, but still the model as a whole is complete. Now to mount it and start seeing just how good, or not, this performs. Installing the mod is straightforward, although I did have to make a small modification to make it work for me. First, start by making sure the printer is off and unplugged. Disconnect the stock fan's power cable and unwrap the wire. Remove the top mounting screws for the stock fan shroud. On the new shroud, position the M4 lock nut in its mounting point and go ahead and attach the blower fan. It's easier to do this now as the lock nut will be hard to access later. Swing the fan out of the way for now. Here is where I ran into a little trouble trying to mount the shroud. These smaller lock nuts would not stay in place enough to tighten down the bolts. I decided to hold the bolts in place upside down with a Allen key and tighten the nut from the top using a ratchet. It may not look as nice as the other way around, but it works for me. Next, swing the fan into position. There are grooves on the inside of the shroud that will hold it in place. Friction will do it if nothing else. Plug in a new power connector, red to red, black to black, then wrap the cable so it stays out of the way of the fan. Plug in a printer, turn it on, go to the fan speed settings, and make sure the fan starts up. If not, you may need to flip the connector around. Now, with everything up and running, I decided to print another shroud to see the impact of the new cooling solution. While there wasn't a huge difference, I did notice that the stringing that occurred on the roof of the first shroud wasn't as bad on this print, so a definite improvement over the stock cooler already. I went ahead and installed the new shroud to take advantage of the better quality. One drawback to this mod is that the shroud is bulky and blocks you from seeing all but a small fraction of the nozzle. So leveling the bed and cleaning the nozzle is going to be a bit tricky without removing the shroud completely. Now it's time to add another Benchy to our fleet and see what improvements we get from the improved cooling. And well, it has to be said, this is the best quality Benchy I've printed so far. Of course, still not perfect, but the overall print quality has definitely improved over previous iterations. This is most evident in two key areas. The first is this little hole on the back. In both previous prints, the round shape is not clearly defined and distorted, but now it's nicely defined and sharp. The other area is one I mentioned at the beginning of the episode. The top of the front window is almost perfectly smooth. No stringing or drooping at all. A stark contrast to previous Benchies. These two aspects of the model and the overall improved quality demonstrates how important it is to have a proper cooling setup for any printer. So whether you choose the Dii Cooler or any other aftermarket solution, you'll definitely see improvements over the stock setup. Special thanks to my subscribers that recommended the Dii Cooler mod. You peeps are awesome. Links to everything mentioned in the video will be in the description. Well, this has been Patrick CK. Like and share if you enjoyed this content. Subscribe to get more videos when they come out. And hope to see you all next time. Thanks, everyone.